What's up, guys? It's Jay, Morning After Kill, and I'm back here on Gotham City Imposters. In my last video, I outlined the class that I was using. It was inflatable insoles, a nimble, double submachine guns, extended mags, and I have the energy drink just to give me a little bit of extra health so I can survive just a little bit longer. Now, the problem that I've been seeing is that a lot of people are building their classes to actually try to undo the weaknesses of their body style. So if you have, say, a Mighty that's on roller skates, or you have them on glider, it does help out the mobility a little bit. But the problem that I see with this is that it's not playing to the strengths of the character. The strength of the character is that he's slow, he's immobile, but he can take a large amount of damage. That mindset, you're going to want to have to actually accentuate what his biggest advantage is, and that's his health. When I see people with body armor and horse healthy, I don't really get mad at that, because the fact that that's how the character is supposed to be played. The more hit points that he has, the longer he could last, and that's going to give him the advantage when you're going on a one-on-one firefight, that you're going to have to keep mobile to stay away from him, because the longer that he can stay alive, the more of a threat that a Mighty is going to be towards you. Now, this is the same thinking that I go in when I make my Nimble class, because my Nimble class is the longer I can stay alive, the longer I'm a threat to you. If I have a mobile Mighty on roller skates coming at me, and I'm using my Nimble class with my boots, I've accentuated my speed and my jumping abilities even more. So now the advantages that I did have over him, even if I wasn't on roller skates, even if I was, running around just plain Jane without any type of gadgets for mobility, then I'm still going to have the advantage in the firefight, even with him having roller skates. But now that I even have a bigger advantage, now that just offsets it and it puts the firefight into my hands, that I can actually easily handle these encounters. So when you're talking about easily handling these encounters, you got to think about the way these maps are laid out. You really don't want to be in tight, close quarters with this type of class going against the Mighty, because you're not going to be able to jump around, you're not going to be able to evade. You want to be able to pick and choose your battles, and that's what I love so much about this class, is the fact that I don't have to actually, you know, stay in the firefight. If a Mighty or a Burly is shooting at me, I have the option to just pack up my gun, run away, reload, drink my energy drink, and reassess the situation on how I'm going to take out this Mighty from where I'm actually at. You have a Mighty that's running straight at you. Always have like an exit plan so you can get out of the way. And that's always going to be the key thing with when you're playing with a fast class that can't take a lot of damage. You're basically going to want to avoid people. So if you're hitting them from the side, you're hitting them from the front, that's exactly where you want to be. And the biggest thing that I say with these classes that can help out is being unpredictable. There's a lot of people that take the same routes. You'll notice that there's a lot of like very common grappling spots in this game. Right here is one of them. People like to grapple up here. They also like to grapple on top of the lights. That way they can kind of snipe at you from up top, and by the time you realize they're up there, they usually have their sniper scope aimed at you. So that's what I'm saying, is play to your strengths, weaknesses. We got this guy trying to hatchet me right here. So I'm going to go ahead and evade him, let my teammate pick up the kill. I'm going to drink my energy drink, and now I'm back to full health, like I never even gotten that encounter, and I get an assist for an easy 50 XP, and that's exactly how I like to play this game, is not so much as trying to maximize my kills. I'm trying to minimize my deaths, because the longer I can stay alive, the more time I have to kill them. People want to go ahead and rush out there and get a lot of kills. That's great, but getting a lot of deaths isn't going to help your team out at all, especially with somebody like me, because I do play a lot of team deathmatch. I like to roll solo, and objective matches, I feel, are a little bit filled with a lot of pub stompers, and what I mean by that is people that party up with about 4 or 5 friends, and they go ahead and get into a lobby, and they play the objective like a madman, and that's great. I love seeing that, but I hate going up against that, because I don't play with a team very often. I do, I've met a few people on the Gotham City forums, I've met a few people in lobbies, and we've had some fun, and it's a very, very big disadvantage to be going solo into a game by yourself against a group of objective players, because then you're really going to get your ass torn up in a very bad situation, and that's exactly the type of situation that you don't want to put yourself in where you have an organized team trying to play against you, because 10 to 1, they're going to have classes set up 100% to everybody's strengths. And that's what I was saying. Like, they'll have motivators, they will have mighties, and they'll give you everything that they could throw at you. And it's just not a fun time playing against an organized team by yourself. It can pose a real fun challenge, but not a lot of times when you're playing against a competent team. So my name's Jay, Morning Afterkill. This was my Gotham City Imposters video, just talking a little bit about class loadouts and how you set up your classes. Hopefully you take some of the tips and tricks that I gave you and you apply them to your gameplay, or leave in the comments below how you feel about this situation. My name's Jay, Morning Afterkill. Make sure you guys rate, comment, subscribe, and I'm going to see you guys later.